What's the worst thing you've heard someone say about the deceased at their funeral? My friend's father passed away a few years ago, and a buddy of ours shows up out of the blue. We haven't seen this guy in a long time. We would send him texts, call him, send Facebook messages, but he never responds. So anyway, he shows up at the funeral and our friend says, "What the hell, Brian? My father has to die for you to hang out." There was no funeral for him. His sisters wanted one in the "it's the right thing to do" sort of way, but the rest of the family, his mother included, were in camp "why bother?" A lot was said, as this was the man who had abused my grandparents for drug money for years, stole from family members, including the birthday money of small children. I taught the younger cousins how to hide their holiday cash from him, faked cancer on multiple occasions to gain sympathy and more money, and broke down my grandma's front door when she didn't want to deal with him while my grandpa was dying in their house. There were two that stand out. Oh, he actually did die of cancer? About time. And the real ice cold one from his mother. It's for the best. Everyone stood up and spoke about how much they missed him and what a great man, friend, and leader he had been. His daughter stood up to speak last and said, "I don't know who you people are talking about, because my father was nothing like that to me my whole life." My sister said about her own 17-year-old son who committed suicide, "I was going to throw him out when he turned 18, anyway. I have actually never seen her happier. She was the center of attention. Everyone consoling her, people sending her flowers. It was so disturbing that words fail me." My very Christian grandmother, who is in the beginning stages of dementia, talked about how great my grandfather was in bed at his funeral. It was actually kind of sweet, but the timing wasn't great, and I don't know how much her children wanted to hear about it right then. Backstory: there is a dentist in the ground level of the building where I work that a lot of us go to. Well, 2 years ago, she killed herself. News started traveling around, and the only thing the woman behind me said was, "Bless her heart, she was so convenient." After grandma's service, we were discussing where to go for lunch, when Gramps tells cousin 10, "You stay here with the stiff, we'll pick you up later." I loved him from my grandmother about my grandfather. Backstory: she was the babysitter, 16 years, for him, 26 years, and his first wife. He fell in love with her, divorced and married my grandmother. They had two kids together, and he stayed madly in love with her. She had two more kids that we know, but don't talk about, with someone else, the man she sometimes refers drunkenly to as the real love of her life. Grandpa stayed with her another 10 years, before she left him in a backwoods town in N, Georgia, and she left to NWFL. He never remarried, became an alcoholic, and died of cirrhosis and Alzheimer's. I know he loved her to the very end, and sometimes talked about her while having a bad memory day. She showed up at his funeral drunk, on the back of a current man friend's bike, and cried loudly about their great love story during his service and time overseas, during which we know she didn't wait for him. I wanted to punch her. Honestly, sometimes I can't be in the same room as her. It's amazing to me that all four kids, my mother being the firstborn, turned out half decent after their fucked up marriage. Half joking statement: he was the worst, but at least he got the family together for this occasion. I have a 1910 local newspaper obituary for my grandfather's brother, my great uncle, who died when my grandfather was 12. It reads: John Doe died walking on Goose Gap Road with friends Saturday night when he fell on a knife. He was well known as a wicked and godless boy who brought shame to his family, but his parents are good, faithful, church-going people, and our sympathies are with them. My biological father's longtime mistress spent her time during the eulogy talking about all the profound emotions she felt when they were making love, and how she knew from that he was the one, her children, from a man she divorced to be with my father, were sitting right in front of her. While on his deathbed, he woke up one of his last times and used his time to scold her bitterly for reading a magazine while he lay dying. She considered it a life-threatening and endearing moment. While recounting his legacy, she got almost every single detail of his professional life wrong and pointed me out as hopefully walking in my father's steps, knowing I hated him. The only other person to talk was the priest. My father was narcissistic, a psychopath, and a bad person in ways that aren't mentioned in pleasant conversation. All he cared about in life was power and glory at any and everyone else's expense, and he was buried at the funniest and most undignified funeral I have ever seen. It was almost therapeutic. 10/10. It wasn't exactly about the deceased, but as my parents, my brother and I arrived at the crematorium to see my uncle off, my mum went smells like a barbeque. During his sermon at the funeral, the preacher said that he thought it odd that the deceased insisted on having a church funeral, given that records and personal testimony indicated that he had never stepped foot in church during his lifetime. When my grandmother's brother-in-law passed away, my grandmother asked me to be a pallbearer, since they were having a hard time finding anyone that would agree to do it. During the funeral, nobody other than family showed up, and when the minister asked if anyone wanted to say anything about the deceased, there were several people that shouted out things like "good riddance." He had been a man that was widely hated by the community as well as his family. He spent his entire life swindling anyone, including members of his own family, out of everything that he could. Ooh, the boss gave a very Michael Scott-like eulogy. First, he asked for a moment of silence, then talked through it. But the cringiest moment was saying how much the deceased cared for his ex-wife and daughter. "I see how much child support comes out of every one of his paychecks, and he never complained about that." At my father's wake 20 years ago, the man married to my godmother gave a speech. He started with "Bill was a very flawed man," and went on to badmouth my dad for 5 minutes. This from the smarmy alcoholic a shat that hit on me at a bar 2 years later, and was universally regarded as a dick. "We are all flawed, but my dad was one of the greatest men and best fathers I have ever met, aside from my husband." The funeral was standing room only and full of people whose lives were touched by my dad's kindness and ability to make people laugh. I wanted to punch my godmother's husband in his face that day. He committed suicide a few years back. Back in high school, we had etiquette class. One year we spent learning about the proper etiquette for funerals, and the biggest two things she taught us were to not make it about ourselves, and to never say the words "at least" to a grieving person. The next year we go to her husband's funeral and someone says to her, "At least you taught us all the funeral crap last year." Needless to say, that kid did not end up passing the class. We can always hope our understanding of heaven is wrong. Priest, speaking about a deceased friend who was an atheist, but his parents insisted on a church funeral. He said it repeatedly, and in different ways, implying that it was a shame he was going to burn in hell. A great friend of mine died a couple years ago. He was known for his amazing sense of humor and the sound of his laugh. When his wife asked me to speak at his funeral, I started thinking about how, if he were alive, and we were going to someone else's funeral, he'd figure out how to have fun. So I played a game, and opened it up to his friends, challenging them to give me a word I had to work into the eulogy. In the end, I came up with the word myself. As soon as I thought of it, I knew he would have used it. The word was ejaculation. I won the challenge. When my grandfather died, there was no funeral, because literally no one had anything nice to say or remember about him. He sexually abused me and his daughter, he beat his wife and sons, he was unemployed for months at a time, and didn't do anything to support his family, and he was a racist swine. After his wife, my grandma, got his ashes back, we all went back to her house, and talked about stuff, and had a good time. It was honestly the happiest I've seen that side of my family act in a long time. Me and my cousin were late to my granddad's funeral, because we took his pork box to for a spin. Before it was repossessed, we showed up and quite a lot of people were pissed. To which my cousin said out loud, "Only had one chance to drive that car before it gets taken away forever." A few sniggered, but quickly shut up. Being fair, my granddad was a fucking dick. I haven't heard this, but I read it from one of those memoir books that explain what it is to have Asperger's syndrome. The woman telling had been called out for laughing at her grandma's funeral and asked if she hated her grandma. She had to explain that she didn't. She had liked her grandma, and she was laughing because of how sad she was of her grandma's passing. I've posted this before, but during the visitation before my grandmother's funeral, a man from her condo sat down beside my cousin, pointed directly at the urn, and said, "Is that your mom buried in there?" unrelated to my grandma, but the same jackass also complained during the lunch at the funeral when my mom and I were packing up our stuff and leaving. We brought punch bowls and a cooler, and he was bitching that he wanted a drink, but we had to take it away. Took everything in me to not scold his dumpy ass in front of everyone. Not me, but my father went to the funeral of a man he knew while growing up. The preacher said he could tell by looking down on the deceased in the casket that he had went to hell. Then proceeded to preach a sermon about how it was necessary to live a morally upright life so that the people present didn't go to hell like the deceased man had. Some friend I used to have in high school suffered from depression and autism issues. He was a nice, lovable guy who wasn't that smart, but always tried to make everyone feel better. One day he stops coming to school for a few days and me and some other friends begin to suspect something. Turns out he killed himself. The family invite my family to the funeral because I was one of his only friends. At the funeral, the vicar blatantly and irremorsefully talks about how this guy was a sinner for killing himself and trying to preach from the Bible. This is why I'm now an atheist. This happened at my elderly grandmother's funeral. I guess to deal with the grief, my grandfather told everyone he approached the very graphic details of her death. We don't know what exactly caused her death, but we suspect some sort of intestinal blockage, including describing what her vomit looked like. I stayed near him, so I could always hand him tissues, but let me just say hearing every detail about my grandmother's death multiple times at her funeral was not fun. After my grandmother and grandfather both passed in their homes, about 2 years apart, we all gathered up at their property. My dad, with absolutely no shame or foresight, says in front of everyone, "God, I just want to burn this damn eyesore down now," in regards to their home. It was just heartbreaking to hear him so heartless. Mind you, this is the day my grandfather passed away, hours afterward. Not at the funeral, but when my aunt died, there were some quiet hushes that it might have been a drug overdose or suicide, because she was a nurse and probably had access to some drugs. She was just kinda fat and died of heart problems. It was mostly all speculation because the autopsy took so long, but still it's pretty morbid to think about. On that note, she was also a donor and her family was shocked to find out that the hospital wanted to take some of her parts and use them for other people. I think they ended up using some parts, but my aunt didn't want her to have a closed casket. If you're going to be an organ donor, talk to your family about it ahead of time, because there's never a good time to find out that somebody needs new skin or leg bones right when you find out your aunt died. Funeral where the mostly religious family couldn't stop talking about how deeply religious the deceased was. Just listening to that, you'd have thought they were a hardcore fundamentalist and had a sudden revelation about the true meaning of things on their deathbed. The deceased was an atheist. Very easygoing. Didn't care what anyone else's beliefs were, so long as you treated other people fairly. Pretty sure the revelation was, after heavy pressure to convert, an offhand comment along the lines of, "Oh, whatever, if it makes you happy," very close to the end. It was me, but I don't know if it's actually that bad or not. My great-grandmother had died, and I had known her very well. We were close. But I looked into her casket, and she had her hair spiked, it was short, her nails painted, and had some makeup on. She never styled her wig, never wore nail polish, and never wore makeup. I just looked at my dad and said, "It's not her, just the body she used to be in. It just wasn't her anymore." Same story as a lot of other comments, priest slash minister whatever, went on about how we all needed to accept God, because our family friend was definitely in hell. Someone threw their phone at him, and got him right in the throat. You could say that shut him up pretty quick. Some wank stain very loudly informed the entire funeral party that my grandmother, whose funeral we were attending, used to give blowjobs for a fiver. My grandfather punched him, and a good old-fashioned bar brawl broke out. When the cops arrived, my grandfather advised that we say we weren't involved, whilst being covered in someone else's blood. When the various people were telling nice stories and eulogizing my wife's grandmother, all she had to say on the subject was, "Who is this woman they are talking about? We must be at the wrong funeral. The grandmother I had was a psychotic bitch, not this loving, God-fearing saint these people are talking about. I came here to see her dead body with my own two eyes, so I know she didn't just lie to spite me. Let's go. These people are fucking crazy. I'd spit on her grave, but I might have to talk to a relative. I was like, damn. You have to be 10 different kinds of awful for people to show up at your funeral just to make sure you are actually dead.